They say a picture's worth a thousand words, so with these thousand words, I'll paint a picture in your mind that breaks the rule of thirds. Let's go right back to the start. What better way to begin? Before too much of the corruption, the temptation and sin. Before the gloss was taken off, back to sandcastles and grins. Before the world we were living in became riddled with riddling. I had a very normal birth, no wise men did attend. Born into my family as son, brother and friend. I had a normal start to life with a very normal infancy. And over the years many events did influence me, but there's one that stands out now with a special place in my mind. And the more times I think back, the more new memories I find. When I was 4 years old, out in France, I almost died. A wave swept up to the shore and took me back for the ride. And in that moment of fear, I gazed below normal tide. And that's when the depths of the ocean showed what was really inside. I saw a man sat just below the surface on a rock. And his wisdom-filled gaze withdrew panic and shock and unlocked an inner calm that let me float down to his depths without any flailing, shaking arms or panic-filled breaths. I swear we sat for hours before words were introduced, just relaxing in a world below the fights and abuse, below the weapons of war, below the cars and the ships. Then when he felt I understood, he slowly parted his lips. The pen is far mightier than the sword, he said, as he stabbed his pen in my leg and the ink mixed with the red. With this action I inject the gift of knowledge instead of all the other cluttered thoughts that will clog up your head. But if at any point you take the spoken word just for granted, these words will stick in your mouth and fall out broken and parted. It didn't hurt for some reason, but I could feel a change inside. But I hadn't really understood what his words had implied. I thought I'd wait for his next words with my mind open wide. And with the guidelines that he gave me, I would try to abide. Again, much time passed with silence being the topic. But the serenity was such bliss, I had no words that could stop it. Then after what seemed like a lifetime had passed, he stopped and looked right through me like I was made up of glass. And at that very moment, I was grabbed from this landscape. As I left this wise old figure, I quickly prompted a handshake and I was carried back to shore, my life saved by my own dad, with no memory at the time of the experience I'd had. And so I went on with my life, these things locked up in my brain. I grew up no different from the rest, everything just stayed the same. Until one day I realised sometimes my own speech was erratic, like the needle on my record would get all caught up and static. And at school this affliction didn't make things too easy. An easy target, so the kids would sometimes laugh at and tease me. I guess there's no denying this made me stand out from the rest. But that kind of thing has never fazed me, I just took it in jest. Sure, the broken stammers of a youth can kind of bring some attention, but the sympathy of a teacher can get you out of detention. And this continued until I reached a certain age, until I started to thrive for knowledge, for every word and every page. All of a sudden the words would just flow off of my tongue. When I got bored of how one sounded, I'd just learn a new one. I started listening to all these people who showed great use of each word, feeling the buzz from every single line from Gil that I heard. The way he manipulated the language and really made it develop, as he told another story from 125th Street and Lennox, and Mr. Mojo Rising, the American poet, had enraptured my mind with words and would never know it. I would sit in my room for hours just listening out for every underlying meaning in the words he would shout. Then I'd put on the specials to hear their social commentary. You couldn't help but get drawn in, sometimes even involuntary. And the way that Rakim would take my mind on a journey to a kind of lifestyle and scene that never used to concern me. A completely different world to the one that I lived in. But I could connect to the language and the passion within him. So I started to write, inspired by those here before me. I'd found an outlet for my thoughts, a way of telling a story. So I wrote, and I wrote until I felt it was time to put some of this stuff on tape. And then I started to rhyme. And once I started climbing, I knew there was no way I could slip. And that's the one true birth of this here Scroobius Pip. The one with the leather ties and weathered eyes, whose 37 clever lines left 37 severed minds. The one that speaks but never lies, and sometimes fails but always tries. And the more he writes, the more he finds it pays to bleed between the lines. They say a picture's worth a thousand words, so with these thousand words, I'll paint a picture in your mind that breaks the rule of thirds. They say a picture's worth a thousand words, so with these thousand words, I'll paint you one big picture in your mind that breaks the rule of thirds.